10 years ago, I suddenly got the idea I have to check out Ireland. I didn't know anything about it, but I took my family and we came to Ireland and we drove through the whole country, and then we decided this should be our home. And since then we are living here. My work is really rooted in the Austrian tradition of art, and I mean the old Austria. So Kafka would be a part of that, and Schiele and Klimt and many of the great writers and painters. So that is really what is the basic influence in my work. But then it was also the fact that I was born after the Second World War in Vienna. So the city was partially bombed. Everybody was really completely depressed. And it was a new start. So I felt the last breath of the Holocaust. It was all there. Nobody would talk about it. But as a kid, I felt it. It was there. And then what came into Europe, Germany, Austria was the American culture. So here was Donald Duck, my savior. So, and it was Elvis and Jimmy Dean. So it was, I had so many strange and contradicting influences from my childhood on that I think when you look at my work, some of it you might see there mirrored. I never wanted to become an artist as a kid. I always thought I want to be a revolutionary or something like that and change everything. Being an artist, I thought, should be really boring. Like, I always thought that these are people with big beards and a French hat and standing on an easel painting something abstract, and I hated that because I wanted to be a part of the new culture, of the street culture, the protest movement. So for me, it was the Rolling Stones, the blues, it was comic strips. So I really rejected everything that had to do with traditional art. But so when I started to paint, and that was when I was 18, and there was this one moment when I realized that in that society there would be no place for me. Because everything I checked, I said, oh my God, it wouldn't work with me. And then I was, suddenly I had this revelation that there's one last possibility in that society where you have a relative freedom, and that is being an artist. So you make your own rules, you have no senior to tell you what to do, and you're free. So I knew I was an artist. If you take all the influences that I was exposed to, and I think that's true for any artist of our times, we have so much information as never before in history. All of that you can see in my work. Like, my work is about human existence, about people. So, and the central theme is in my work is always children. It's always about children. So I want to take the side of a child. And show the world seen through the eyes of a child. So children in my work are often also abused and victims, but on the other side, you can tell that they have a certain strength and power. That's why also in this exhibition you see it's always about children. So children are always in the center of my narrative paintings. And I think all the paintings are kind of telling a story, and it's almost like as if there is 1 second frozen out of that story that you can see. And you as the onlooker would have to complete the story. I just realized that nobody could talk. And I knew as a kid there was something. Because you look at the pictures of your photographs of your parents and grandparents and uncles, and they're all in uniform. So as a kid I thought, my God, cool, they're all soldiers. What happened? So nobody wanted to talk. But I was a very insistive child. I always kept asking and digging. And when I started to learn about the Holocaust, it was hard to understand that this mediocre, scared people would be responsible for such a tragedy. That was something that changed my life, especially when I realized that most of these war criminals would never go to jail. So, and then I lost my trust in a justice system. And I started to research. I wanted to know what's really going on. And I'm still on that journey, and I'm still researching. And art was for me a way to continue my search. Ireland is what I consider my home now. And that's true for all my family members. Like, it's the first time in my life that I thought, this is home. I never had that in Austria, and I really must say, through the distance in years and kilometers, looking back to Austria, I really like Austria. And I appreciate all the qualities that they have, and I like to go back. But living in Ireland, that is the first time in my life having the feeling of having a home. And half of the year I spend in Los Angeles, in downtown, which is the absolute contrast to that here. When you live in Tipperary, Waterford, I live exactly at the edge, at the border, like that's the opposite. In downtown, it's the air is polluted, it's like if thousands of homeless people, it's the end. You can see, this is how the Western world is ending, the fall of the Roman Empire. And if you come back here and see the people in these country pubs dancing and singing, you think you're on a different planet, you know?